Resident Evil.
It all began as an ordinary day in September. An ordinary day in Raccoon City. A city controlled by Umbrella. No one dared to oppose them. And that lack of strength would ultimately lead to their destruction. I suppose they had to suffer the consequences of their actions, but there would be no forgiveness. If only they had had the courage to fight. It's true that once the wheels of justice begin to turn, nothing can stop them. Nothing. It was Raccoon City's last chance, and my last chance. My last escape. September 28th, daylight. The monsters have overtaken the city. Somehow, I'm still alive. Okay, we've got to get out of here.
What? What do you think you're talking about? I just lost my daughter out there!
How dare you tell me to go back outside?
I'm sorry about your daughter, but there isn't gonna be any rescue. We have to get out of here.
No! I'm not going anywhere. I'd rather starve to death in here than be eaten by one of those undead monsters! Now leave me alone! I told you! I'm not leaving! Never! Just get away from me.
Thank you. Get away!
Brad, hang in there. Why isn't someone doing something about this?
I didn't know you were still alive, Jill. The police aren't trained for this kind of situation. What could they do? Listen, he's coming for us. We're both gonna die.
What are you saying?
You'll see. He's after STARS members. There's no escape.
Oh. Thank you. Thank you. Say so, but my head feels like it's about to explode. Anyway, name's Carlos. Glad to meet you, lady.
Jill, Alpha Team, RPD's STARS unit, who do you represent?
STARS, I see. Well, I'm a member of the Biohazard Countermeasure Force sent by Umbrella Incorporated.
Sent by Umbrella?
Hey, don't look at me like that. What did I say? Do you have a problem?
Oh no. It's him!
Pain is pleasure thing, okay?
Just deal with it. That thing wants me dead. We've got to get out of here. Wait. I have to ask you something.
I know. You want to ask me out? All the foxy ladies love my accent. It drives them crazy.
I have to know. Why did Umbrella send you here?
Because we're on a civilian rescue mission.
Oh, you're full of it. They're the ones who caused all this in the first place.
Look, we're just mercenaries, hired hands. Do you really think the master would tell his dogs why they have to retrieve the stick he just threw? Listen, if you want answers about Umbrella, you're asking the wrong guy. Believe it or not, we are here to rescue civilians. If you can trust me, join us. Think about it.
Thank you.
You're one of the survivors from the rescue team, right? I just ran into your teammate, Carlos.
How did a girl like you manage to survive?
Hey, I'm no ordinary civvy. I'm a member of STARS.
STARS? You mean the RPD Special Force Team?
Ugh. Hey, is someone wounded back there? Oh, this looks bad.
They're coming. Get ready! Fire! Fire! Stay together!
Calm down. You're safe now. Everything is gonna be okay.
No. Don't come any closer. Stay away.
So Jill, did you decide to help us out? It looks like we're the only ones who survived. We should work together.
No, we can't trust her.
Why? But Sergeant, we need her help. Our unit's down to you, me, and Lieutenant Mikhail. That's it. And Mikhail's hurt bad. If we don't cooperate, we won't be walking away from this mission.
Fine. Then let's go over our plan. We're moving to the Clock Tower area, which is the designated landing zone for the extraction chopper. Once we get there and give the signal, the chopper will fly in and pull us out.
That's a lot of ground to cover. I don't think we can make it on foot.
The main problem we have is that the landing zone is cut off from here by the fire. So we have no choice but to use this cable car to navigate through it. Fortunately, we can also use it as a moving shield to get us through the worst areas.
That works for me. Good plan, sir.
Okay, people, let's get moving.
Jill, put this on.
I'll check over there.
Nikolai!
Mikhail, do you have some kind of death wish?
My people, they were wiped out by these monsters. I can't stop just because I'm wounded.
But can't you see those monsters are also the victims of Umbrella?
Are you accusing me of taking it out on them? You don't seem to understand something. We're not really involved with the company. There's no reason for any of us to take responsibility for this mess.
I know that. And right now, that's the only reason why I'm trying to cooperate with you.
Sorry. I feel so useless.
Don't. You fought hard and have the wounds to prove it.
But I'm still alive. My men aren't.
Don't think about that now. Just rest.
I could not save my men.
No! Thank you. stars.
No! Don't make me do this, Murphy. I don't want to shoot you.
Kill me.
I finished.
Not human.
Wait, we don't have to do this.
Please hurry. Before I lose consciousness. Before too late. Kill me!
Thank you. Stars. Thank you.
Carlos? I'm sorry about Murphy, but there was nothing you could have done.
Yeah, you're right, Jill. I'll operate the cable car.
Nikolai won't be joining us. Come on, let's go.
It's looking good. Mikhail! Hey, what's going on in the back?
Mikhail!
Oh,
Carlos, I don't believe it. You're alive.
I'm not sure how we're gonna get out of this town.
What are you talking about? We made it!
You don't get it. They have no intention of letting us make it back alive. Do you really think we can trust their great evacuation plan? Huh, it's just a piece of paper.
But we don't have any other choice than to trust them right now.
No, if we're gonna die, then we should get to choose when it happens.
So that's it then, huh? You're giving up?
No. I just... I can't handle it.
Thank you.
Jill! Jill! Hey, don't die on me. Jill! Jill!
October 1st, night. I woke up to the sound of falling rain. I can't believe I'm still alive. Carlos?
It looks like our roles have been reversed from when we originally met, huh? Don't worry, Jill. This chapel is safe.
I've been infected by the virus, haven't I?
Hey! Take it easy.
I'm okay. Don't feel any pain. But that's what bothers me. If I can't feel anything, then what does that mean?
Don't give up, Jill. I'll take care of you. Whatever you do, don't let that virus beat you.
If I turn into a zombie, don't hesitate. I want your word that you'll kill me.
Thank you. There also appears to be a slight fracture in his right arm just below the elbow. However,
what happened?
What's going on?
I'm one of the supervisors. That's all you need to know.
Wait!
Thank you.
Thank you.
barely made it. How do you feel?
I'm okay. What happened to you?
I just fought with that monster. I've got some bad news. Nikolai's still alive.
But I thought he was dead.
That guy doesn't know the meaning of the word dead.
What is he after?
I don't know. All I know is that he is our enemy. I'm sorry, Jill, but there's something I gotta take care of. I promise I'll meet up with you later. But don't worry.
Thank you. All supervisors, mission terminated. Return immediately. Repeat. All supervisors return immediately. Over.
I'm quite impressed you've managed to stay alive up until now.
And you seem to be doing a pretty good job of looking out for yourself. How about helping out?
I have no intention of helping you.
Because we're nothing but pawns in all this?
In a manner of speaking, you are. Our employers wanted a detailed analysis of the zombie beings which were created through infection by the T-virus.
You're saying that they deliberately sent in a military unit to be butchered by their creations?
Not exactly. Although the conditions encountered on this operation were extreme, it was an unexpected outcome that the team would be wiped out. We were only required to collect live data from the subjects.
Ah!
Another mutant!
Rescuing you is becoming a full-time job.
Thanks, Carlos. I owe you.
Listen closely, Jill. They're going to launch a missile directly into the city as soon as day breaks.
At dawn? But that's only...
I know. We don't have much time left. We have to split up and find a way out of here. And hey, watch out for that traitor Nikolai.
Nikolai?
Thank you. Warning. Proceeding with operation in treatment room. Please evacuate immediately.
Stars.
Stars. You're still alive. Such persistence.
Nikolai?
Sorry, but there is no escape from here.
What happened?
Carlos, the choppers.
I guess this is it then. But I don't want to die in a place like this. This isn't over yet. I'm not giving up, Jill. We still have a chance. I am not going to give up! Jill!
That's it. We've got to find a way out of here. Now!
Warning. Missile attack confirmed. Warning. Missile attack confirmed. Emergency level D. All personnel evacuate immediately.
Checking system. Checking battery. Warning, there is not enough power to activate the system.
Connected.
Warning. System overheating. Entering cooldown mode.
Jill!
It's over, Carlos.
What are you talking about? Don't you hear that? There's a second chopper, and it's here to rescue you.
But who is it? Who could possibly be looking for me?
It doesn't matter. We just have to be there when it lands.
Now we have a rather unfortunate turn of events. It seems that the President and the Federal Council have passed judgment over the civilians of Raccoon City. The President and Federal Council have ruled that the Backless Terminate operation is the best course of action for this extreme situation and have since executed. Based on that fact, Raccoon City has been literally wiped off the map. Current reports have the death toll surpassing the 100,000. Hearts go out to those poor civilians of Raccoon City.
Thank you.
Bye.